Mis Bonitas. So, since 2017 has started off on a good note, I wanted to actually go through my beauty trash and get rid of it all so I can start off the new year fresh. So, a lot of these products are just from the fall time up until most recently. I've been working on some Project Pan stuff, so I have lots of videos that are up right now of things that I'm working on. These are the products that I've used up or don't like, or if they're brushed and stuff, they just no longer work for me. So let's get into this bag of goodies, yeah? Alright, so let's just go really quickly through. This is the Ruta Beauty Raspberry Citrus Makeup Wipes. I got these at like the grocery outlet. I try to use them for the face. They weren't really good, so I end up using these more often or not for like swatches when I was playing with makeup, or if I just need to like wipe off mascara. They weren't really good for anything else but that. They have like green coffee oxidized in this. I don't know. I would not repurchase this product right here. This one I just recently finished up. I love this. Got this at Ross, if I'm not mistaken. This is the Tea Treatment. This is by Creighton's in England. It's rejuvenating, innovating, whatever, body scrub. It has walnut shells. It was Tea Treatment. It was pretty awesome. This was 16.6 fluid ounces. Jesus, I think I actually purchased this and myself and my boyfriend were using it since like October, and we just finished it up actually this week. Definitely would repurchase this. I have something else already, so I won't particularly get this, but if I'm looking for, I definitely recommend it if you're looking for a body scrub. I tried one of these out, got these, they're called My Beauty Spot, the Loofah Complexion Discs. I got them for $2.99 at Ross. I used one, did not like it. It's just, it's, we put your soap on it, you get it wet, it kind of fluffs up a little bit, you scrub your face with it. I just didn't really like it as an exfoliator. I have facial like cleansers that have exfoliant beads in it, and then I just didn't really like it. It was too rough on the skin, so I'm just tossing it. It was sadly $2.99, not well spent. This is from a Project Pan that I was working on. This is the Andalou Cleansing Gel. This is the Clarifying. This is my face wash that I use during the spring and summertime. Absolutely love this. Finished it up. So glad that it's gone. I started to finish it up in November and it's finally completely done. This is a toner I was using, the Balancing Toner Intense Defense Vitamin C by Avalon Organics. Got this, looks like at Ralph's, it was on sale for $2.79. It had 8.5 fluid ounces. It took me pretty much a whole year to finish this up, so I did enjoy it. I would not repurchase it for the price that it sells at normally at grocery stores or at like Long, CVS, all that jazz, but I have already some other toners I'm trying out, so this is okay, but I would not repurchase it if I did not have to. My holy grail, the Body Shop Chamomile Waterproof Eye and Lip Makeup Remover. Love this. This is honestly like my second to holy grail. The only other one that I really enjoy is Lumini. Currently using Neutrogena right now, but I do repurchase pretty often when I decide to do the buy two, get one, or buy three, get two from the Body Shop. So if I have to buy again, I will definitely get it then. Paul Mitchell Super Skinny Serum. This was 5.1 ounces. This took me forever to finish. This thing is like 2.5 years old. I would not repurchase it. I got it at Ulta. It's okay, but I have other like argan oil products to help soothe and make my hair soft and stuff like that. And everything this stuff says it does, it did. If my hair was like already in good standing, if like right now we moved, I'm in an area where there is a lot of dry, like hard water, so my hair is super dry. I do hot yoga, so it's kind of fried, so I have to really work on keeping it conditioned. I would not repurchase that. This, I'm sad to see this go. This is what I actually would use to foil my eyeshadows with. This is the Aromatherapy's Hydrating Skin Spritzer. It had lavender in it. It was 8 ounces. I got a grocery outlet. Really enjoyed this product. If I saw it again somewhere, I would repurchase it, even if it was a different set. I did like it also to like refresh my makeup. I used it for a little bit as a setting spray up until I switched over to the Urban Decay All Nighter. So if you see this brand, definitely check it out. It's great if you put it in the refrigerator and like spritz it during the summer over the face. It's really nice as well. A holy grail product that I don't find in grocery stores like CVS, Walgreens anymore. I think they only sell this online. They don't even sell it in this size. This is the Lumini Pure Radiance Night Cream. It has the vitamin C plus with Arctic Cloudberry. This was in a project pan I worked on in November, completely and utterly gone. I scraped everything I could out of it. Love this. This is my night cream that after I wash my face, tone my face, I have a pre-lotion that I put on before this kind of like to tone corrector. Then I would put this on top when I want to like go to bed. It was just amazing and awesome and I absolutely loved it. Body wash, the stress relief eucalyptus tangerine, Bath and Body Works, love this stuff. This was like a discontinued scent from the semi-annual sale like a year ago. I would have purchased it if I saw it. This is the Coconut Exfoliating Sugar Scrub. You see, I like sugar scrubs. This one I got from Marshalls for $5.99. This is 19.4 ounces. This one was really gritty. It was a little uncomfortable at times. It definitely, when I was a little more dry, especially in the elbows, the knees, or any other areas that really needed to exfoliate, this was great for it. But yeah, it took me about 4 months to finish it up, and that was a lot of help towards the end from the man friend, the boyfriend. One of my go-tos for the spring and summertime, the pore minimizer but clarifying section from the Andalou Natural. This is my go-to toner during the spring and summer because my skin being all kind of funky donkey and all that jazz. This is my first perfume I've ever completely finished up. This is the Kat Von D Saint. This is the Eau de Parfum 1.7. I've had this perfume like forever. I had one of those rollerballs that had Sinner and Saint, and I like Saint a lot. I gave like Sinner to someone else, and then once I finished up that side of it, I bought myself a new one. So I finished this up like December last month. I was so excited. It took me forever. But I would definitely repurchase this perfume if I didn't already have a bunch of other perfumes in similar scent. This was sweet, nice. It has, I think, undertones of vanilla or sandalwood. If you like sweet, you'll definitely like Saint. So that was in a project pan. I was super excited to finish that one up. A couple other products that I finished up from Project Pan. My Lumini Bright Now Visible Repair Tone Corrector. I had this for like in my collection forever. I used it, I really liked it. I put it down, I completely forgot about it. And then when I focused on Project Panning in November of last year, I started using it again. I realized how much it was actually great for my skin. I had cystic acne, and so I had a little bit of like discoloration scarring from like those bad boys that got away from me, and using this, it just really changed and made my skin a lot better. I remember I took a picture and sent it to my best friend in New Mexico, and I was just like, look at my skin. And I had been using this regularly day and night after my toner, before my moisturizer, for like a little over, like 6 to 7 weeks. And she's like, oh my God. I'm like, I have no makeup on. She's like, your skin looks fast and like, it looks amazing. What have you changed? What have you added? And this was it. So this is a holy grail product. You can only buy it online via like Amazon or like eBay. So I would definitely recommend if you're looking for something to help like correct tone, like dark spots on the skin, definitely try this out. I'm already using one. I need to get another backup of it, but I absolutely love it. This equals awesome skin. Another product that was in my project pan was Andalou. This is an eye serum. This is for brightening. Put this underneath both day and night. It had 0.6 ounces. It was a little expensive. I got this at like the natural food store. I wouldn't repurchase it unless I had a coupon. I really like this brand though. I kind of got into them last year when I was focusing more on health and also health and beauty, and so I've tried out different products from within this line and I really enjoy it, though I would not repurchase it. I would definitely recommend if you're looking for a more like animal, like no testing on animals, non-GMO, vegan free. I would definitely recommend checking out this brand. Two products that I finished up, they were in my project pan in November. This is a light and medium in the CC cream, the travel size by It Cosmetics. I had light and medium. Light I kind of used when I was lighter, medium, and then I mixed them, and then they're both gone. So really excited. I think they were like $15. I would not repurchase it. It was a good product. It was great for those days when I wanted like light coverage and I set it with a pressed powder. But I'm kind of trying to get my favorite items into my collection when it comes to skincare and like products for my skin for makeup. So that one's good, but I'm still looking for my holy grail, like CC cream or BB cream. Two things that gotta go. These, I believe, are from, they were like the MAC Cosmetics version of beauty blenders. And I've had them for quite a while. This one's all nasty and crusty. And this, just, they're old, and I've used them several times, wash them, clean them, but they just don't quite feel the same. So blending out like makeup, it just, it doesn't apply right. So both these are gonna go bye-bye. Trying to see what else? Finished this up haphazardly. This is the Inglot Cream Powder in 89. This was like a summer color of mine. Huge pan. Remember when Inglot was like the rage on YouTube, but then it got all quiet and stuff like that? I got this when I was in Las Vegas, as the pan falls out. I got this in Las Vegas. It was great. It was a nice consistency. I, you know, summer color, used it 1 year, kind of put away when I got lighter. And so I decided to kind of hit it back when it was time. So I'm glad to finish up that product. I did really enjoy it. I wouldn't repurchase it just because Inglot's kind of hard to find. We don't have any stores here in San Diego, so whatever works. Utterly Smooth Hand Cream, it was nice, 99 cents or dollar store. Would rebuy it if I need to. This product is the Lumini Bright Now Visible Repair 2-in-1 Eye Cream and Concealer. So the concealer, I did not finish. It dried out, that's on top. But I did finish up the eye cream, and that was pretty awesome. It's down here at the bottom, all gone. I had this for a while. I actually completely forgot I had a concealer. And anyways, great eye cream. It was like helped kind of with my dark circles underneath my eyes. I would repurchase it if I could find it, but again, it's one of those products from Lumini that I think got discontinued or reformulated it, so they don't have it around anymore. Let's see, Ariana Grande's Ari Perfume, the Roller Bar, like the scent. I would repurchase the bigger set, another sweet one, if I had the money and I had the space. So right now I'm working on some other perfumes, but it's definitely one of my faves. Let's see, Milani Eyeshadow Primer, finish that up. You've used this before, love it. What can I say? This is the Blemish Vanishing Gel from Andalou. So this is the stuff that I would actually use for spot treatments, for if I had a zit or whatever would come up. I'd put it on in the morning, I'd put it on at night before I went to bed, and it would help reduce the redness and help make that bad boy disappear, which was awesome. I got, let's see, a lotion. Got this when my little brother graduate boot camp. This is a goat milk lotion, hand cream, hair, Adonis, Greek god. Amazing lotion, smells super good. Like someone's like, what does that smell? It smells like pears. It was this thing. I think I paid $2.99 for it. Definitely would recommend if you're looking for something super moisturized and super thick. If you have really dry hands or whatever like that, definitely recommend it. But for now, I don't need any hand lotion. The Milani Light 10 Multitest Face Primer, or Face Primer, Face Powder, as I try to break my nails. Hand it gone, bye-bye. I use this as my setting powder and powder during the summer in particular. Two brushes that need to go bye-bye. This one is my e.l.f. one. This thing likes to come apart. I just happen to put it down. I have several of these, so not a big deal. This one I'm kind of sad about. I don't have, again, it's one of those things where the ferrule comes off. This is from the Made by Lexi. She had a whole little brush set that came out. So this is the larger flat shader brush, and yeah, the thing just came undone, and I've been using it for now. I've been using it since it went missing, and I apparently lost the bottom part to it, or I would have kept it and tried to re-glue it. That was my bad. But it just now, the way I have my brushes set up, this is just super inconvenient because I like have to change the grip and whatever. I guess I'm just being lazy. So these are going to go bye-bye as well. Two mascaras that I either used up. I used up the Almay One Coat Triple Effect. This is in black. I really like this one. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Impact Mascara. I did not like this one. I think it started to dry out halfway through. Ooh, now it smells bad. So yeah, I just didn't really like the consistency of this one. It didn't really do anything for my lashes, so I said bye-bye to that. Have some, let's see, samples in here. I have a sample of the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer. I really like that, though I'm not gonna spend a bunch of money on this primer because I have a bunch of other ones that I'm using right now to try to see which one's my favorite. I finished up the Tarte Clean Slate Poreless 24 Hour Perfecting Primer. I really enjoyed this. This took me a while to finish up. It's one of that clear gel, similar to the Smashbox primer for the face. Again, have lots of primers, so this one was good, but I don't necessarily need to repurchase it. I already have a different type of primer anyways. Now these products that are here in my bag left, oh, this is one I finished. This is from rockersis.com. It was an indie brand. This was the color Platinum Bond. It was like a frosty white. It was a sample baggie. I actually finished it up. And that goes in the empties because it is so hard sometimes to finish up mineral sample eyeshadows. So these products in here, either the consistency went bad or they're just old. This one stopped working. This is from the Body Shop. It was their 100% natural lip roll-on. The ball stopped moving, so I actually had a lot of product in it. It just, the ball won't move. Oh wait, it moved. I don't like it. It stinks. No, we're not keeping this. The ball moved now, but I don't like it. This is an older lipstick of mine that it just, the color I have so many of, and yeah, this is the Revlon Color Stay in the color 375, which was Ripened Red. You can see I have quite a bit of product left of it. I hate throwing lipsticks away, but just, it doesn't smell right. I have similar colors to it. The formula, now it's dry, so it goes bye-bye. Same thing for this one by Kat Von D. This is Underage Red, just one of those minis. It looks gross. The is super dry. As much as I enjoy like this little set that I had, I have other reds. I didn't like the change in the consistency, so it had to go. I tried this liquid liner from W7 in black. It was it's a 0.268 fluid ounces. I hated this eyeliner. I was trying it out because I was hoping I could come to like it. It's one of these type of brushes to it, which I normally like, but just it was not, did not work for me. What happened when I did a wing is if my eyes were for whatever reason watery, it would smudge and go away. Didn't like that. This is a Hard Candy Concealer in Light Pale. It's the stuff when you get the camouflage one. This was the pencil I kept. It's old, it needs to go. This is a Stila, I lost the top, a Stila Smudge Stick Waterproof Liner in Stingray H Black. This, as much as like, there's actually a decent amount of product in here, but it's become hard and it tugs on my eyes and it's just not worth it to me to keep a product that I know I won't use, I skip over because I don't like the way it feels. Last two and I'm done. This is a lip conditioner from e.l.f. This was the lip balm. It was like that pink, light pink one. This came out a long time ago. This cream product, the smell, it just kind of smells funky. There's a lot in there. I think I only used it a couple times and just sat in my collection. And it's one of my oldest lip balms. It just needs to go because I know I'm not going to use that one. And I don't like the fact you can stick your finger in it. I prefer ones that you can just kind of run on your lips like a lipstick. The last one was actually one of the things that YouTube made me buy. This is the NYC Smooth Skin Bronzer in Sunny. And I hit pan on it. But one thing about this bronzer, I have swatches from earlier. It's patchy now. And it just doesn't look right on my skin tone. Whether it is during the winter, whether it's during the summer, it just, I don't know. I remember I loved it, and now, not so much of a fan. This is actually my oldest bronzer in my collection of drugstore, but I think in general it's my oldest one. So that is all of my trash. I'm so excited to actually be able to get rid of all this crap and to start collecting stuff, haha, of my project pans, to start working on this stuff to make room in my collection. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, show me your trash. If you do these videos or you enjoy them or you hate them, let me know. Either like it, dislike it, or let me know in the comments. Hey, Lorena. Hey, Lo. Change up your videos. So until next time, guys, I'll be talking to you very soon. Besos. Bye.